I really like the music here. It's super rad. It is like the most 80s thing ever. Oh my god, man. Oh god, oh god. Okay, there we go. So these guys that kind of just pop up like for the forever, man, for the rest of their days. They're just gonna be popping up here. So just keep your wits about you. Always make sure that you're gonna be like ready to stop in place if you have to, because then you'll just run into one of them. Oh yeah, freaking ghosts. That's right. Yeah, more freaking zombies. They're pretty nice for farming though. They're kind of like the snakes, right? Whoa. This wagon looks like it's seen better days. Yeah, for real. Good lord, broken friggin' wheels on it and everything. Good lord. Anyway, what was the other thing? Oh yes, Splatoon dropped on the 29th as well. That was the other like big thing that happened besides my monitor shitting itself. Yeah, Splatoon is officially out. It is getting mixed to positive reception from reviewers, which is great. I think it's absolutely incredible game. I won't go into full details yet because I want to see if the whole longevity thing I talked about in my impressions on the test fire is true or not. So I'm gonna play it for a couple more weeks and see if things start getting stale. Apparently there's supposed to be like regular like updates that kind of like give more content to the game. They're like free updates too, some of them. So I'm excited for that, just to kind of see how it goes. But I don't know. There's lots to the game, I find. I like the single player a lot, honestly. Single player was really good. Ooh. That last boss was friggin' awesome. I won't spoil a single thing, but it's pretty good. Oh, hey, save guy. Anyway, Splatoon dropped. Monitor shat itself. I mean, monitors are pretty easy to find nowadays anyway, so it's not like, it's just the matter of getting it. Oh no! Oh, look at the giant spider. I thought I heard. Roddy Tops? Get away from her, you monster! Oh my god. I don't even know what kind of voice I'm gonna give Roddy Tops. Maybe I'll give her like a New Yorker accent. the Canadian version of a New Yorker accent. Oh my god, this is gonna be great. That was close, you were almost a meal for that thing. What are you doing here anyway? I live here. I heard this island had monster web coverage, so I... Stop with the web jokes! Ah, sorry. Well, are you gonna help me down or not? Not a chance! For all I know, this is another scheme so you can eat my brain! I ought to leave you here to rot. But I'm already rotting! Ooh, fine.
Oh, jeez.
Well, what have you got to say for yourself? I think you owe me an apology for all the trouble you caused. I'm sorry, but... Oh. Oh, my legs. They're going numb.
She's turning into like a Jewish grandma. That's fine.
Oh no, that spider bit you, didn't it? Forget about it, I'm a bad girl. Just leave me here. No way! I can't abandon you in the woods!
Why not? You were going to leave her here to rot. I mean...
That would be much too grim, I guess. My house is through the forest. If you can get me to my brothers in time... Just hold on, Roddy Tops, I'll save you!
Oh god, yeah, so now we have this part of the game where we are carrying Roddy Tops through a bunch of different trials where one hit kills you. So, this is loads of fun, as you can see. Shit just kind of pops out of nowhere, and there is absolutely, like, there's a bit too much of this. I don't know. I don't understand what the point of this was. If this was to try to teach you to, like, really pay attention to your surroundings because you have no weapons now, or what? Because there's another part in the game that teaches you stuff like that, so I don't get what the point of this was. Because if anything, it just really limits all your mechanics. But anyway, I don't know. Whatever WayForward wants to do, I guess. This was just really like, why? Why was this put in here? But I mean, it's fine. I'm sure I'll die a couple more times because this part is pretty tough. It's a bit on the cheapy side, but I find things get a little more fair later on in these sections. But yeah, you'll see, it goes on for like an awkwardly long amount of time. Like, you go through a lot of rooms. Like, you would think, like, oh, like, maybe you go through, like, 5 or 6 rooms that all get progressively harder. No, there's, like, there's probably close to a dozen, maybe over a dozen rooms. Like, there's a ridiculous amount here, but, you know, whatever. It's, you really are just playing the waiting game a lot of the time, but you kind of have to figure out where everything is as well. Started walking too soon. Because the way this section works is that there's a lot of things that you just don't see at first, and then they pop out. So you really gotta take your time if you don't know where everything is. I have a fairly good idea of where everything is, you know, because I've played through this game a couple times already. But the couple times I played it was mainly on the 3DS version, so who knows what they switched up here. They already switched up that whole platform thing. You know, that sequence break to get the last squid in Saliva Island, so I don't know, though. Maybe, I don't know. Maybe there is, like, something more to that. Maybe I just messed something up, because that's very possible. Oh, God, what is this? The Super Mario Bros. Super Show? I'm sorry, viewer. The friggin' pasta. Pasta. I don't even understand how somebody can say pasta. That's just my accent getting in the way again. Ah, for me it's pasta. 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 I don't ever say pasta though. That's pretty good. I'm not Minnesotian. So Minnesotian? I don't even know what the word would be. Just Minnesotan? I don't know. All I know is that the name of that state just always makes me thirsty, so. Oh God. Oh man. Yeah, so now we got like little bug guys underneath tombstones. I don't know why the tombstones have like a TW face, you know? I don't know why that is, but I mean, maybe that's just their mood. Their emoticons, you know? Oh boy, whoa. There. Yeah, so as you can see, this level really goes on for like a weird amount of time. Like, it's really long. Like, way longer, I don't know, in my opinion, it's way longer than it had to be, but, you know, and, like, for me, it was like, why even bother? I guess because, like, you see these guys in a later level, I think, so I guess, I don't know, you're introducing them, I guess, I don't know, they make kissy face at you, and it's really weird. It's very strange, it really kind of messes with the the implications of some of these enemies, their motives and such, I don't know, it weirds me out, I don't like them. There, so you gotta get that guy to, you gotta bait that guy down there, and then you just run for it. I mean, I think it would be cool if some of them, like, moved slightly faster than Shantae, but you always, like, slightly outpace them. So there's not really any, like, instant, danger here if you just keep running, because you always run faster than them. So, I don't know. Now we're above ground again, but we're gonna go underground one more time, because I'm pretty sure you go underground one more time, yeah. So, see? This is like the expert course now, so now the levels are like a little bit harder. Now you get like these weird like ghost spermy guys. I don't know, they're weird. Actually, they look like that Pokemon. What's that 5th gen Pokemon that's just like a straight up eel? Yeah, it reminds me of him. The one before he has like arms. I forget what they're called. Well, I know that one of them's called Tynamo, and then the other one is Electric. I just don't remember the middle guy because middle sibling syndrome. Poor guy. Anyway, oh geez. I got a comment also. I forget what, it must have been part 3, I think it was. Somebody was addressing my opinion on like the transformation thing and stuff. And somebody was asking like if, oh my God, Jesus Christ. If in Half Genie Hero, like how I would want the transformations to work. And you know, I'm sure it sounds generic, but this is how I want them to work. I want it to be like a friggin' Zelda game where you just push start and you have an inventory full of different dances you can do, and you just assign the dance to like A button or B button, or you know, like whatever button they want to use, Y or X or something. And then you just push that button, Shantae does a dance for like a second and a half, and then she transforms. That's what I would like to do. Or even just have it be like just a fully like fluid dance, like in engine, like the screen doesn't even pause for you to do your dance. Like, make it something that can be easily, like, comboed into the rest of your actions, because that would be awesome. Anyway, whatever. Oh, just in time. Yeah. Oh, my hero! Yo, sis, what's with the peeled shrimp? Oh my god, friggin' dude, Abner, don't get on my case, dude. Unless she's here for dinner, she should turn tail and hit the bricks. Abner? Some big brother you are! Can't you see she's injured? Looks fine to me. What? Hee hee! What a ride! Roddy Tops! You dirty double-crossing— Hey! Shantae, is it? I got something I've been meaning to say. Or I guess he should have like a very New Yorker accent as well. They are brother and sister after all. I ain't too good at making friends. But you've been good to me and Poe and my sis here. It's just that pirate gal has a real way of getting into your head and making you hear what you want to hear. Guess I'm trying to apologize for some bad calls in the past. Teaming up with that risky boots, dumbest thing I ever did. Oh, but now the tables have turned! Shantae is a hypocrite! Oh my god. Oh, well, that's okay. Yeah. Poe and little Rod is here, all's I got left of whatever life I once had. I don't remember much else. But you always make her smile, and I gotta be grateful for that.
Wow, I don't know what to say.
Forget it, we're square.
No, you're very human-shaped.
Where the devil's Poe? He's been back, he
ain't been back in a while. You're using too much slang, you're confusing me, Abner. You are much too casual in talking. He was supposed to fix my wagon so we could skip that creepy forest.
Well, if either of you see him, tell him to check in or I'm gonna get peeved.
Oh, snap, dude. Well, geez. I guess if you're gonna be that way. I found a heart squid, though, just sitting in your house. Don't know why you guys were keeping that hostage. Probably gonna eat its brains or something. Anyway, any butts. Now we gotta go in here, yeah. Oh, hey, I found Poe. He was hiding behind a rock. Poe, your brother sent me to find you.
Hey, you're that coffee banshee. I remember you.
Genie. Half genie. Well, former half genie.
Thanks, whatever you are. I was scavenging for wagon parts when I got stuck in here. You like to help people in need, right? Yeah, how about taking a look at it?
I'm no mechanic, but sure, I guess.
Follow me, the wagon's this way.
Okay.
This is all that's left of our wagon. Those wheels I can repair no problem. But that axle will never run smoothly again without some squid oil.
Oh, look at that! Looks like we would have had to go and backtrack and do all that side quest stuff in order to get the squid oil, but we have it. Yeah, man. Here, take it.
Excellent. Ever since we split off from the zombie caravan, we've been in short supply.
I don't know if there's ever exposition explaining why they left the zombie caravan, but anyway.
I can have this fixed in a jiffy.
You gave squid oil, okay.
Cool.
Hey, you're pretty amazing, Poe.
Thank you, m'lady. What do you say we take it for a test drive? It could get a little dangerous, just saying.
You're sure Roddy won't mind?
It's no problem. Just remember to hold on tight.
Okay. God, how does that horse doesn't even have vocal cords anymore. How does it neigh?
Wow, she handled beautifully. I couldn't have done it without you, m'lady, here.
You got the shriveled thing. Okay, thank you. I could imagine, it's a carcass.
How sweet, I'll cherish it always, but what exactly is it?
What, you don't like it?
No, it's great.
It's from a dead guy.
Oh,
I'll be around in case you ever need a ride. See ya.
Okay, thanks, Poe. Poe has wings, I just realized that. Poe has straight up wings. Oh my god. Oh god. Anyway, sorry. I was cutting out parts of the friggin' section beforehand because it was getting repetitive trying to do it because I kept dying in that part where I was carrying Roddy around. But I was talking about a commenter who was saying, I'm sure you guys would have heard some of it, so I'll just try to like sum up my thoughts on things rather quickly. Like a commenter talking about how I want transformations to work in Half Genie Hero, and I basically just said I want it to be just an inventory system where you equip the dance, and then you do the dance by just pressing the button, and then you're transformed.
Oldie moldy leftovers, hungry feed a shriveled thing.
Okay, here you go. We can just squeeze through those bars, but anyway.
More, bring more delicious thing inside.
Okay. I won't go in just yet, but I'll just wrap up my thoughts very quickly here. So in the original Shantae, right? When you danced, nothing like paused around you, right? So everything was still like moving around. But then, I'm pretty sure in Risky's Revenge, things were the opposite, right? Everything was moving in Risky's Revenge. What am I saying? The reverse. Things weren't moving in Risky's Revenge. So there are these very obvious like safe zones where you can just dance in Shantae, and kind of part of the challenge of Shantae, and was also kind of a cool like little like sub mechanic, was searching out these safe spots to transform. So there's a bit of a strategic edge to things. And that's, I don't know, I found it really cool about the game like that, and like among a million other things in the original. Whereas in Risky's Revenge, you could just kind of transform anywhere, which really made the game feel less like, it definitely made the game less challenging, but it made it feel more that it was just like, oh, here's the spot where you gotta transform. So then you sit in place without any danger and transform, and then do the thing you have to do in your transformation, and then you turn back. So, I don't know, the transformations, not only did you have to sit there and like cycle through all your dances to transform, but it just felt so unnecessary. Like, I'm just sitting there and I'm just like, in Zelda, you just equip the item and you get past the thing. Like, it was easy. You know, it was easy to predict and ready things ahead of time. There are certain areas you can't get to as some transformations, and then there are other places where you have to turn into Shantae and then turn into another transformation once you're done being Shantae. I don't know, it felt very clunky, I found. But anyway, I'm just rambling on about nothing now. In the next episode, we're going to go into the next level. I believe it's called the Cackle Mound. And this is actually a really cool level. It's nothing like you would expect it to be. You'd expect it to have a bit more of like the shadow mechanics, like the original like zombie themed area in the original Shantae had. But it's nothing like that really. It's quite interesting. It reminds me a lot of like the Forbidden Woods from Wind Waker, and I think you guys will for those of you who played the game, you'll know why. For those of you who don't, you're going to see why, and it's super cool. It's a very organized, like, well laid out dungeon as well. I think it's one of the best designed in the game. But anyway, we'll see it all in the next episode. So, I hope you all have a very good life, or afterlife, if you are Roddy Tops. Because, I mean, she's already dead. She's there. She seems like she's having a great life. She's just getting friggin' mortal humans to carry her around so that she doesn't have to walk around. God, what an asshole. friggin' Roddy Tops. Peace.